Come on. Come on.
Chicken and corn.
Well, hello there. This is the Black Gray News here. Welcome to another segment of Nefarious News. Bring the weird and crazy stories around the world and bring them to you live and in living color. This is a very nefarious story, I must say. After woman bites tiger truck stop camel, animal given precautionary antibiotics. This is the picture of the camel. It's very, very nefarious. Let's take a look at the pictures. We have a video we'll show you at the very end. As we can see here, tiger struck top Casper, the camel, one of the animal's attraction at the truck stop, looks no worse for wear. Seen Sunday, September 22nd, at Gross TT, last week, when a Florida truck stop driver and her husband crawled into a camel's enclosure at the truck stop. The camel sat on the woman, who used her teeth to bite the camel's testicles. Oh my God, that's very fucking nefarious, I must say. Now I want to stop there. Why would you put your mouth and on a camel's testicle? And why would you bite it? Like, this woman is very, very nefariously freaky, I must say. Let's back to the story. To escape, according to the Iberville Parish Sheriff's Office, a woman's husband threw doggy treats under the Casper the Camel's fence, which is about 6 feet high. The lady encountered trouble after entering the enclosure to retrieve the dog. A veterinarian prescribed antibiotics Monday for a camel that lives behind an Iberville Parish truck stop after a Florida woman told law officers she bit the 600-pound animal's genitalia after it sat on her when she or her husband entered the enclosure to retrieve the deaf dog. Sheriff's office documents obtained Monday alleged Gloria Lancaster, 68, my God, this lady is 68, biting testicles. So you gotta be out of your mind, lady. And this man's gotta be out of his mind if he doesn't get a divorce. Edmund Lancaster, 73, let their unleashed dog under the pen behind the tiger truck stop at Gross TT, 16 miles west of Baton Rouge. The couple told deputies the camel attacked the dog without provocation. But the sheriff's office said the couple and their pooch invaded the camel's personal space. I like how they put that in quotes, personal space. Yeah, you did more than violate his personal space. You put your mouth on his genitalia. That's gotta be nefarious. Last week, Wednesday, hump day. No pun intended. By shoving it and swatting at it. Iberville officials had said Sunday that the Lancaster of Milton, Florida, told investigators she had to bite the animal's testicles to get it to stand up. Well, I bet that thing was not standing up. You can't bite any genitalia and to get with the intent to get it to stand up. It's not how you do that. You're supposed to put your mouth up. I'm not going to tell you what to do. Let's continue the story here. Edmund stated that his wife bit the camel's sick, is that what that is? Private parts, and the desperation to get the camel off of her, as it bit him on the left elbow, an affidavit said. After the camel stood up, his wife was able to get free and grab their small dog and get outside the fence and the barbed wire fence. The deputy said that the camel did not harm Edmund Lancaster. The injuries to Edmund is consistent with crawling under the barbed wire fence, not with being bitten by the camel. Security footage did not match the Lancaster's account. Of course not. That lady lied, and both of them did. The deputy wrote in a report that the couple had given numerous inconsistent verbal statements that couldn't be corroborated through surveillance video and others who saw the encounter. The sheriff's office report said that the couple feeding their deaf dog treats near the fence and the investigator found bone-shaped treats inside of the 6-foot-tall enclosure that's surrounded by signs warning visitors to keep out. So you were warned to keep out and you didn't do it. Gloria Lancaster said she suffered injuries to her abdomen, neck, shoulder, and arm, and head. Medics transported her to Our Lady of the Lake Hospital in Baton Rouge. According to the Acadian Ambulance Service, witnesses said Gloria Lancaster told witnesses that her animal had broken ribs and a collarbone, and that she later asked for a cigarette from a witness and smoked it with no apparent trouble. Tiger Truck Stop Manager Hamlet Bozier said that the veterinarian checked Casper on Monday, and he appeared to be fine but was given antibiotics as a precaution. She described the towering animal as a docile and gentle giant. Sheriff's deputies cited Lancaster's for violating the dog leash laws and trespassing into the enclosure, both misdemeanors. The sheriff's office didn't find reason to hold the truck stop liable for their injuries because of the signs warning visitors to stay out. The camel is one of the several exotic animals the truck stop has on display for visitors, including a miniature horse, kangaroo, and a coyote. I think that's how you say that word. A member of the raccoon family that's not native to Central and South America. But the roadside attraction has drawn fire from animal rights groups who for years have sought to remove the animals, including the tiger that lived there in the Casper's pen before it was euthanized around 2017. Owner Michael Sadlin said that the truck stop hasn't had any issues with his animals attacking people, including Casper. He said camels sometimes react by sitting and laying on things they see as a threat, but typically friendly with people. He added that video he reviewed showed that Edmund Lancaster stayed in the enclosed for several minutes after his wife got out and continued shoving the camel. I'm not sure if he was angry at it, or what, Sandlin said, but it strengthens our argument that they were up to no good. He said that he plans to release the video at a later time. Calls to the phone numbers messages left on Lancaster's social media accounts weren't returned Monday. Yeah, I wouldn't respond if I had a wife that was putting her mouth on a camel's genitalia. It's very nefarious, I must say. Let's take a look at this video, guys. Give me 1 second here. It's a beautiful camel.
Okay, so. Hey, he had his hat off and just popping them like that. And then the guy actually walked away from them 3 or 4 times. He had 4 or 5 times he could have got out of that pen. And he proceeded to walk back to swat at him some more.
We'll be ended up hearing.
First of all, they went trespass. Then they proceed to antagonize something that big.
Yeah.
Why would you antagonize? And we go in there, we bathe him, we walk him, we play, we kick that ball and he kicks the bag at us and stuff, you know? It's like when you antagonize him and somebody
there for camera,
you know, strike back. It all could have been prevented a few steps that way to that restaurant.
Yeah.
There's always employees and they open 24 hours.
Yeah.
I love my dogs with all my heart. Yeah. I have 6 of them and believe, baby, they all relate to me.
The camel.
If it got loose in somewhere where I wasn't familiar with that big animal,
yeah.
I'm not going to crawl underneath a fence. I love them. Yeah. My instinct would be run for help. It was a small dog, but he wasn't. From what I could see, he was looking at it and stuff, but it didn't look like he was doing anything to the dog, but I guess he thought it was his friend once it made it in there, and I guess when they started swatting at him, it just, I guess, made him mad, which most animals do.
Yeah, you can't be swatting at animals. They're very aggressive, depending on the nature of the animal. Well, this is a very nefarious story brought to you by the Black Gray Hughes. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, so long.
Now that's Huggy Pacino certified.
I live in this shit.
Why you stay a bitch?